Okay. Let's hit this game. Oh, there we go. So this is actually my second time playing this game. The first time, I had some mic issues, so my voice could not be heard, which kind of sucked, but it's whatever. Anyway, this is OutMode. It's a game that I saw on Reddit. Looked pretty cool. Demo was pretty neat, but there was like some issues with like collision and everything like that. Car got like stuck to the wall. Some little things that I had thought could have been done better leading up to the full release would just be like the first person mode, adding something to show you like what gear you're in or something like that. But I actually did post it in the discussions for the game, and the developer did come back saying, you know, like this is something that they're thinking about. So it was nice to at least know that they were looking into that sort of stuff. Why can't I go back? Settings real quick. I want good resolution, please. Scan lines, FPS scanner, sky grid, HUD. How do I go back to... Okay. Alright, resolution screen size is perfectly fine. Actually, can I make it a little bit bigger for me? No, it doesn't look that way. Okay. Using music controls, I am using a controller. They got cars, you got all sorts of different stats for them. I actually think that I might have some other cars because... Controller isn't integrated very well on the main menu. I'm gonna say that for sure. Let's go race, solo... Gonna start off with Chrome Shores. Oh, that's how you do it. Okay. We're gonna do the first race with the first car. We go normal, manual transmission. I want some more rivals. Confirm. Alright, let's go for it. Anyway, game is... It looked decent. It sort of filled that like vibe that I was looking for. Let me make sure that I actually have audio. I did. I didn't have mic audio the last time that I was playing, so I have to be sure. There's also a chance that like this music could get claimed, but I don't think I got claimed. I posted the original one. Some things on the stream may be a little choppy, but typically I'll do it. So the interesting thing about this game was specifically the shifting mechanics, because you actually hold like on the controller that I'm playing right now. You hold the left bumper and use the right stick to shift the gears. And it's actually, I would say that it's actually pretty intuitive. I don't typically play with a manual transmission. Got a couple different reviews. Looks like they finally at least added the gear shifter to this. I can take that. There are like weapons and stuff that each of the cars have. And there's like hazards on the road. So it is possible that you blow up. But blowing up only just like sort of slows you down for a little bit. Cockpit view is kind of interesting. Yeah, so I've got a time machine, so I have like a supercharge, and it just turns me into like a DeLorean. Okay. You do kind of still stick to the wall. I wish that, like, at least in the top left-hand corner, that it would still show you position overall. And the last and the least. Like, why not those things? The game does certainly feel a vibe. This might, like, feel like it hurts some people's eyes. What position am I in? Third now. Outrageous speed! It's kind of very arcadey, like Outrun. came second. You earn credits, and with the credits you buy cars. I don't recommend using the controller on the main menu. Alright, let's go ahead and race. We'll use a different car this time. We'll do a different track. Starlight Nightway. We're gonna do the Ickerman. Normal. I'm gonna turn off hazards. Actually, no, I'll leave them. I should have done the full six. I think that, like, hazards, difficulty, and the amount of rivals, I feel like that should be, like, a constant. Like, you should have an actual setting for it. That way you can just hit, like, play game and pick your car and pick your track. Starlight Nightway. This place looks cool. Okay, each of the cars has a different looking dash. It also looks like they each have a different kind of ability. I got the Hellfire Blast, Turbo Killer. Sounds dirty. I am legitimately stuck to the wall. I think that they need more, like, track marks. Because in this first-person view, it's kind of hard to turn it. Needing to turn. Maybe. I could be wrong. Where am I going? Oh, was it? It was just a point to... It was a point to point. Alright. And the game crashed. Got it? That's unfortunate. Benefactor. Normal. Turn hazards off. 6 rifles. Let's go for it. Yeah, the Benefactor, it's like a Lambo looking one, I think, if I remember correctly. Downtown Boulevard. Off the wall. You really gotta do it quick. As long as you're holding your clutch, the less time you're actually accelerating. Thank you. And there is a drift button, but drifting just ends up sending you into the wall. You get stuck there. I honestly have a better time just sort of braking and turning than I do drifting. Yeah, I tried drifting. I mean, then again, it could just be me. It could just absolutely suck, but... I want to say that I'm okay at driving. Say though, visually the game's got it. I dig visually what this game is doing. And for the most part, I'd say that the controls are like 75% better. Well, not okay, no. Controls are there. Physics are like 75%. Or just like, what, a split second warp somewhere? That was weird. Okay, let's try a different one. Lightning Canyon. Go again with the benefactor. Normal. 2 laps max. Arrival. there's almost no point in using them. At this point in time, like, I'm not gonna want the game anymore after playing. There's just too many things that sort of just detract. So for one, like, I don't feel like there's any feedback for what you do. Like, there's no... You almost never have anything to do with any of the other racers. And like, it has a look, but it doesn't really have a soul. I feel like after you hit like a wall, like, auto put yourself, it says that it would automatically put you in first gear. Do it. I would very much like to be put back in first gear. I work myself into sixth place. Sunset City, I'm gonna go back to the Copernicus. Turn off the hazards. Normal again. Confirm. Cause at least with the Copernicus so far, I understand the abilities, and they seem helpful. Also, the amount of credits that I have, it's not adding together. It crashed again. I will play through all of its maps, at least. Yeah, because I noticed I'm not gaining credits. Neon Mountains. Some loading issues. Like, once you get into the game, the frame rate seems to be pretty solid. And it's only the way that it's capturing. Like, in game, it's fine. Turning around wasn't so hard. Might be a little more okay with that. I was trying to drift a little bit. I was drifting far too early. I know that. Maybe I should try one of these races in automatic. I don't have to worry about the gear shift. Still counted as a collision. like this look. And I do appreciate the like, what I would say would be like a pretty deep cut callback to Back to the Future with the whole Copernicus name. Because that was the name of Doc's other dog, or like Doc's original name or something like that. I don't know. Yeah, I still find better just driving for it. No real need for drift. Although drift does earn you knowledge. Drifting is just a little unpredictable. Let's see what my number of credits are. I just earned 3-3 and I had 2080 or something like that previously. Oh, I only have 3560. Alright, last one. Nostalgia Lake. I have no idea what I'm selecting when I'm doing this with a controller. Normal. I'll leave hazards on. I'm going to do 4 laps. I'm going to do a 4-lap race. 4 laps for me to be absolutely in the back. I will have no choice but to lose. Was that supposed to be like Camp Crystal Lake? Thank you. made. Try drifting. I'm gonna blow up soon. don't know, man. Like, I really want to like this game. Like, I should definitely have enough. I feel. Anyway, the game, it's interesting, it's fine, like, it is almost there. Sound-wise, I like the music, I like the jams, it's fine, it's great. Probably turn down the engine noises just a little bit, it's fine. Visually, love it. If you like that sort of aesthetic, 80s retro, like, neon light sort of thing, you'll love it. It's great. The cars? They look fine. I love the fact that each of them has like individually designed elements and like the in-car view is all different, everything like that. I like that each of the cars has different sorts of abilities and things. That's cool. Oh, this is Kit. Yeah, that's all really cool. And like control-wise, it actually does work pretty well, with the exception of, like, drifting. And then if you get turned around, it takes forever to get yourself turned around. But it's just like, why? Why? Like, I almost want to know, like, just even, like, a little blurb. It's like, far in the future, outlaws race to transport goods or blah blah blah, or to determine like who the best in the business is, just something like that. Like, why are people shooting at me? Why are there obstacles? Why is it a death match? Like, is there like some sort of rivalry? give me something. Like, it could legitimately be nothing, but like little dialogue boxes when you select a car, showing you like who the like the driver is. I think they do that for what, like F-Zero? I don't know, like Mario Kart isn't that deep, but you know all the characters from the lore and like you know how they interact with each other. So like it sort of like gives you like a little bit of, I don't know. I'm like trying to justify a lot of stuff with this game, and it's really difficult. Game crashing, that's kind of broken. The game HUD needs some work. And then, like, there's no online. I saw people talk about no online mode. It's just play by yourself, or there's, like, the game sharing thing. Two players at most? And I really want to like it. But as it stands right now, it's difficult. It's difficult to like it for what it is. Which kind of sucks. I think that it should be a little bit, like, I should be able to like this just fine. Anyway, I'm gonna go. I think I'm good on this. I'm probably gonna come back and do something else. I'm actually streaming early today, but yeah. Thanks for watching. Much appreciated. I'll be back soon.
That is one big pile of shit.